Here on this composition book, I sort of had my idea for the movie Stalker sort of planned out here, so here is where the story is pretty much written up. Okay, so I'll read it off. Okay, so Stalker showing around the neighborhood, close up to the house. Killer Stalker goes into the room. When no one notices, showing around the room, Rick drinks a can of Monster Energy and relaxes on the couch. John calls Rick. They talk about watching porn. Rick is on the couch. The killer comes out of the closet with a knife and murders Rick. Line cuts off. John walks to Rick's house without knowing that he is being followed by the stalker. Cuts to the scene where John is already at Rick's house, and then the stalker murdering John. Then the stalker looks around the room, and then that's pretty much it. Okay, so here is where I sort of wrote up some of the dialogue. Okay, so I did sort of like, at the beginning, sort of like a character A and B, sort of to keep track of the characters. Okay, so, hello. Alright, so this is like the first few dialogue. Alright, so it's like, hello, hey Rick, hey John. Alright, hey, I just got out of school. Can you go to the porn shop and buy Guso Milk Volume 1 through 4 in the Vomit Gore Trilogy? Yes, we can watch it together, as in, yes, he'll go and buy it, and they'll watch it. Okay, see you, hello, what the fuck? That's when the line cuts off, but I sort of changed it up here, a bit of the dialogue. Hey, I just got out of school. I was wondering if you'd like to go to the porn shop and buy Guso Milk Volume 1 through 4 in the Vomit Gore Trilogy. Okay, so that's kind of what I, like, had planned out. Okay, so there it is. Now, this movie, I enjoyed making it, but there were a few problems. I didn't like how when the line cuts off, the killer murders one of the characters, then manages to go to the school within a fraction of the second, and then goes and follows the character home and gets there before he does, and then manages to sneak in and murder the last victim. I thought that was a bit bad, like teleporting. You know, it's kind of a horror movie cliche. They did it also in Jason X, and I thought it was probably like a good idea having the main villain, stalker and serial killer, like being silent, not talking, because I thought it'd be creepy, kind of like how they did in The Human Centipede 2. And also, I wish the runtime was just a bit longer than it already was. This movie's a little over, like, 4 minutes and 10 seconds. And I wish it could have been at least 5 or 6 minutes long, you know. Like, that could have been better. But anyways, I learned some good stuff about this film. And also, I changed up some of the color in, you know, like, with this film through editing. And also, my friend, who is a violinist, he helped out with the soundtrack, so there, that was pretty good. And I had fun making this movie. Maybe not that great. It was the first movie I've ever done. I have done some other editing tricks where I walk around the house, but an actual movie with a story with friends, you know, this is a first for me. So, you know, the first movie any filmmaker makes is like a learning experience, and I learned a bit while making the movie. And anyways, that's gonna be about it for this, mainly just talking about how I planned this movie, and, you know, showing, you know, a bit of this and saying what I think. And anyways, that's gonna be about it for this video, and that's it. Bye.